Hi folks, and welcome to episode 38 of the Eve Christie Hand Knitting Podcast. I'm your host Eva, and I'm coming to you from my studio space in Perth, Scotland. It's Sunday, the 12th of March, and it's not been that long since I last spoke with you all and enjoyed your company, but I just wanted to do a quick sort of like little episode about Edinburgh Yarn Festival, which has just taken place over the previous 2 days. And I'm still kind of riding high on it, although I am completely exhausted. I did very little yesterday bar knitting. Much the same again today, to be honest, but I wanted to just tune in, have a wee chat with you guys about all the exciting people that I got to meet, to have a little chat with, the people that I didn't get to meet, because that's just as funny, to be honest. And I have some rehomed yarn. I'm saying some. I was really good. I went with a shopping list for my best friend who couldn't make it. So a good number of these purchases are hers. And I got something for my mum because Mother's Day is coming up in the UK, and I'll show that to you. And I got some bits and pieces for myself as well, which aren't all yarn related, so that's pretty good. So I've just remembered that I'll pop one over here that's completely separate to all the lovelies here, and I don't want to miss anything. So we'll get onto that in a moment, but all the information on where you can find me elsewhere on the internet, including our Ravelry grouping and all that jazz, it's in the down bar just down here, so go press the little arrow, go find all that information, and I won't just talk it all at you just now. Where to begin? Right, let's begin with all the people that I met, and I'm sure that I must have bumped into other people that I just didn't fully recognise. And I'm saying that not because I'm a massive personality, because I'm certainly not. But because no one either realised who I was or plucked up the courage to speak to me really when I was out and about the marketplace. So I went on Friday. I spent most of the day in the marketplace, although I did get along to the sort of last 25-20 minutes of the podcaster meetup at the Podcaster Lounge, which is sponsored by Blacker Yarns, and I was there for the Blacker Yarns introduction of one of their new yarns a bit later on, so I was there between 4 and 4:30. The rest of the time, from about 10:30 in the morning right through until about the back of 5, I was in the marketplace. I was just taking it leisurely. It felt like around every corner I went there was a vendor that I knew, so it was lovely just to be able to kind of wave over and have a bit of chat with them. But no one really recognised me, and I was laughing about it because I'm putting it down to the fact that I've gone back to kind of straightening my hair a bit. So my hair was straightened, I had a bit of lippy on, and I very, very rarely wear makeup. I only tend to do it if it is a big event or like a wedding or something like that. It's just personally, I don't like the feeling of a lot of product on my skin. That is all it is. So that, I thought that was quite funny, and I was joking that, you know, I was kind of incognito. Nobody really knew who I was, and it was great. But if you passed me and you weren't sure it was me, or you felt a little bit too nervous to come up and speak to me, then I totally get it. Don't worry. I just thought it was funny. I did actually get stopped by some people in the marketplace. In particular, I'm going to call them out now, Who and B, who are the creative geniuses behind Cosmic Strings. And I love their yarns. I have shown them to you before. They're actually coming to Perth Festival of Yarn this year, of which, if you're maybe just tuning in for the first time or whatever, I've dipped in and out, I'm the director of Perth Festival of Yarn, which will return on the 10th of September in 2017. All the information on where to find that is also in the down bar here. But Fu and B are coming this year, and we've only ever just really exchanged sort of messages on Etsy and email and that sort of thing, and we just walked by and I just saw this this guy with a big smile on his face. He kind of smiled at me and I kind of smiled at him. And what actually walked past, and then I heard Eva and I kind of turned around and went, yes. And I went, phew. Yeah. And I turned to the tall lady next to him and went, and you must be Bee. So that was really, really funny that it seems to be vendors and dyers and such that kind of recognised me in the marketplace. And people had been to Perth last year as vendors as I was walking about. Oh, Eva, how's it going? So they recognised me as well. That was lovely. But what you really want to hear is about kind of the knitting celebrities as such. Who did I get to meet? Who has a podcast? Who does that stuff? So the one person that I've got to admit that I think I passed, because when I went last year it seemed to be a who's who of knitwear designers. And I didn't feel confident enough to say hi to anyone or introduce myself, so I just kind of smiled, gave them a really big smile to say I know who you are and I love your work and let's leave it at that. But I am sure that I passed Tom of Holland, whose surname escapes me at the minute, but he kind of goes by Tom of Holland. I know he was there teaching. I'm sure I saw him in the marketplace, but I didn't feel confident enough to say, excuse me. That was epic. Louise Scully of Knit British. We had a very, very brief chat. And I must say that most of these people that I'm just about to mention, they were very, very brief chats. Edinburgh can be very, very overwhelming with everything that's going on. And I'm very conscious of people have so much else that they want to get through. So I don't really want to go and take up much time. But just a very quick, you know, maybe sort of 5 minutes. Hi, so-and-so, I'm so-and-so. Love what you're doing. What you up to, what you're wearing, beautiful garment, what have you shot, and let's move on. That's generally what these are, guys. So Louise Scully of Knit British, she's got an audio podcast. It was quite funny. I know her. I know of what she does, and I listen to her audio podcast. I listen to very, very few audio podcasts. But I said to someone else, excuse me, to kind of get past in the podcaster lounge at the meetup. Not everyone wears big name badges, so you wouldn't really know who people are. And I kind of asked someone to kind of excuse myself to get by, and then just as I was going by, I said to someone standing very close, oh, I love your knit. And because that's what you do. If you see a knitted garment at EYF that you love, you need to kind of communicate that enthusiasm and how much you appreciate the other person's work. So I did, because that's just what I do anyway. And I heard this voice saying, oh, thank you very much, it's so-and-so by so-and-so, and it's Maiden so-and-so. And then I went, I recognise your voice. And all I heard was, I'm Louise, I'm Eva. And Louise grabbed me into a massive hug. I love hugs. There were a lot of hugs going down at Edinburgh, which I'm a big fan of. So yeah, I got a big hug from Louise, and we had a wee chat, and I just thought it's funny, so I recognise your voice. Who else did I meet? I'm having a wee look at my notes here. Sarah Berry of North Child Knits. She wasn't teaching, she wasn't vending, she will be vending at Perth. I bumped into her in the concourse. She was in between going to some classes and doing some purchasing of her own, so that was lovely to meet her, because again, she's just another person. I don't mean that in such a bad way. She's not just another person. She's another person that I have been speaking with about Perth, but I haven't actually physically met her before, so that was grand. Sonia from Blacker Yarns, and I'll show you a little bit of acquisition now because it kind of goes into that. Sonia was at the Podcaster Lounge, which is sponsored by Blacker Yarns, like I've said, and she was showing off multiple samples of their gorgeous, gorgeous new yarn, which is Samite, of which I was given a gorgeous little sample. And this sample is in the Drowsy Flowers colourway. Now, Samite is a 3-ply yarn, and it's a silk blend, and it's been inspired by the Pre-Raphaelite Arts and Crafts movements. It has 15 shades. It's a woolen spun yarn. It's 30% Drapey, Blueface Leicester, Bouncy Froth, 40% Shetland, and Guilt-Free Luck Shave, 20%. I hope I'm pronouncing this correctly. Ahimsa Silk? It's spelled A-H-I-M-S-A Silk. So sorry, I've totally butchered that. And 10% fibre from Sue Blacker's own Gotland flock. It's fabulous. It's fabulous yarn. I love probably most. There's maybe one or two of these shades on the shade card that I have that I'm not quite so keen on, for me personally. And all the names have been taken from Victorian poetry. So we have Wild Bee's Hum is a particular favourite name. Burnished Nights, Sunless Hours, Frozen Bud, Bursting Figs, Swallow Soar, Tide of Dreams. Just so, the names are just so evocative. So, show that there. Simba's just come up to come and join me. He's been a bit poorly recently, so I'll leave him as he is instead of sort of lifting him across today. I briefly met Emily from Tin Can Knits, who was on their stall, and I mentioned the bounce that I've just finished. Jared Flood, I was desperate to speak to Jared Flood, just to thank him for being who he is and what he does. Trying to get at him was near enough impossible. He's a very popular figure, no doubts about that. But what I did observe is that when he gets into a conversation with someone, he really does like to talk, and I didn't want to interrupt. And that was a big issue I had at EYF, because I think once or twice I had to say, just excuse me, can I just say, hiya, I'm so-and-so, I love what you do, and I'll try and catch up with you later, because that's how it is. He also got Jared Flood, Eric from Sticks Plus Twine, who is one of these people that I do have to say, I interrupted and I felt a bit bad, but I thought, you know what, if I don't do this, I am never going to get the chance to say hello. I bumped into Eric in the marketplace. He was round about the Loop booth. I spied him with a copy of Opera magazine, but before that I just recognised his voice, which is kind of what you do, you tune in, it's, I know that voice. And there he is, he's standing in front of me, and it just seemed like a conveyor belt of people just coming up and having a chat with them, and it's a very, very relaxed atmosphere, and he seemed absolutely fine with it. But I just thought, standing and waiting and waiting, and I must have looked a bit dodgy or a bit lost or overwhelmed or whatever, and I eventually just said, excuse me, hi. I gave Eric one of my Perth Festival of Yarn bags, just as a little something, because it's nice sometimes just to give people a little something, which I believe he promptly filled, because I saw him at various other times over the course of the day, and he did seem to put purchases in it, so that's good he's purchasing. He obviously found some interesting things. Katie from Inside Number 23. I didn't believe I showed up in her radar. However, when I went over to the podcaster meetup and she was there, and again, I took a wee moment and said, hi, Katie. Before I'd even finished explaining who I was, she just grabbed me in a hug, which was lovely. And she's a lot shorter in real life than I actually thought she was. But she was lovely. She was gracious. She was very, very sweet. That's fab, and I didn't get to see any of her purchases because, again, very, very popular lady, but I do look forward to seeing what she has rehomed. I should say as well, these are no particular order. This is me just thinking, oh my goodness, who did I see? Get it down on paper, and hopefully I've not forgotten anyone. Nathan Taylor, the submetician, we actually went away and had a little coffee after he'd finished teaching. He was struggling with his voice, so I kind of laughed. I thought it was quite funny, because if you watch Nathan, then you will be aware that his podcasts can go on a little bit. He's longer than the average. He does like to talk. He just loves a chat, and I did most of the talking. I just talked to him, so that was really funny. And he was lovely, lovely gentleman. So thrilled to have met Nathan and for him to have taken the time out, because he is extremely busy and was extremely busy and had other things to go on to, that he took just a little bit of time out with me to have a coffee. I also very, very briefly met Andrew and Andrea from the Fruity Knitting, and yeah, I think I've covered most. There were other various podcasters sort of going about, but I don't watch every single podcast out there, and everyone's swaddled up in yarn and carrying yarn, so it's difficult sometimes to know who's a podcaster, who's not, and such. So excuse me for a moment, I'm just going to blow my nose because my hay fever is a bit all over the place at the moment. Now, this is the bit that you really, really want to see, because this is the purchases. Hey, sweetheart. Simba. Simba desperate for a wee pet. So, non-yarn purchases, things to show off. So, I very, very kindly was offered a lift through with my friend Bev, who is the Fair City Knitter. She's got a real passion and flair for Shetland and Fair Isle knitting. And we took another friend, Lezley Taylor, who has been mentioned in a few podcasts because she does very, very cute and sweet little notions. And Lezley started off the day with, let's see if you can see this, if I can get it to balance up now, a lovely little spoon progress keeper. And I got a badge from Leona, who is Rusty Ferret. She owns the Fluff shop in Dundee and she dies under the Rusty Ferret label. So she was there and it was good to see her there. Non-yarn purchases, this. There were only one or two things that I really wanted to get at EYF, and one of them I just couldn't see. And I'm not sure whether I just wasn't looking closely enough, or whether I'm just not meant to have it, or what, but I'm looking for some sort of wooden knitting gauge for swatches. You know, the ones that you get that are a piece of wood and they have the hollowed out section and all the measurements. So I'd wanted one of those, I didn't get one, but this was absolutely desperately on my list. My friend Zoe, who has Queen of Purls, which is an independent yarn dyeing shop in Glasgow. Well, she's an independent yarn shop, but she also hand dyes herself. She has collaborated with a friend to make the most gorgeous, gorgeous needle gauges. And there's two, and I really had to kind of hold myself back because I wanted both. Because this little bear, Ursa Minor. She has Great Bear as well, Ursa Major, who's got more holes with bigger needle sizes, and I wanted them both, and I thought I can't justify both, especially not just now. But she's teamed up with a friend who's actually laser etched them and burnt them. These are wooden. They're just the most perfect little things, and it's got a keyring. So I desperately wanted that. I got that. I'm so happy. Non yarn related. And what else did I get? This is a present for my friend Sue Jatton, who couldn't make it. She gave me her shopping list, which I dutifully got. That's love for you folks. And I saw a little something, I thought I have to take her gift back, and this is what it is, because she's started to really get into Shetland knitting, and I think I got the last one off the stand. So it's Jamieson's knitting bag. But it's the back that's the most interesting. Makin in Shetland. And it's got all the knitting terms on it. How absolutely fabulous is this? And I'm showing it to you before. She doesn't even know about this yet, but she's not immediately gonna watch this. And if she does, that's fine, because we've got a good enough relationship and she knows that I'll be wanting to show everything off. These are just absolutely brilliant. worst at slip, being a woolen vest and gloves and clue and grafter and gansy and, oh, roar. Just socky legs for leg warmers. How fabulous are these terms? So she's got a bag and yeah, I'll show you. I've got one other non-yarn, not purchase, it's a gift, but it goes with something, so I'll leave that aside. So we'll move on to yarn that I got that's not for me. Not one or two or three or four. But six balls of dye Gilpin's Lalland Lambswool. This is Sujatin's knitting. She's going to be joining in the Argyll Snood knit along for a dye. All the details for this and where to find it will be in the down bar as well. And she also wanted another couple of spare balls, so the Snood takes three balls. She's also going to knit hers in the Haar colourway, which is the same colour I'm doing mine. She wanted something spare because I think she's going to be knitting the shawl mitts as well, which is another one of Dye's patterns. She also wanted, and the light's maybe not the best, this is a nice kind of corally pink, but it's called Flame. Let me go and see. Label. Each of these balls is 50 grams and 175 meters, so it's a light double knitting. And she also asked for Laggan, which is a dark navy blue. Oops. Probably not just coming up most true to colour. So that was Sujatin's knitting, and I'm sorry, I'm kneeling up, which is not a good thing to be doing for any length of time, on my legs, and I've got really bad pins and needles in them now, so I'm just going to manoeuvre myself down a little bit. Okay. Yarn purchasing. I went to see Estelle at Midwinter Yarns, and they carry a range of Scandinavian yarns and Welsh wool, and I love Welsh wool. So normally if I'm going to an event like this, my normal purchasing is 4-ply yarn because it's so versatile, and I know if it sits in stash then that's okay for it to sit in stash for a while because I will eventually get round to using it, so no guilt. Hands up here guys, I haven't actually started any of the yarn that I bought from Edinburgh last year. It's all still sitting in my stash. But that's okay because it was all bought with certain types of projects in mind and it will be used. So this bucks the trend because this is double knit. Where is it? Let's get in the right way up. We've got a wee Welsh heraldic dragon here. Is he heraldic? Yes, he's heraldic. He's got his front leg and claws out, so he's heraldic. This is Black and Blue by Midwinter Yarns. It's 100% Welsh wool. It's Blue Face Leicester and Black Blue Face Leicester in here. It's so, so soft. It's got 250 metres, it's 100 grams. And the colour is called Welsh Mist. It's natural. It's just... the light's blowing it out a wee bit. But maybe just hold it here. I love this. This is destined to be a hat and some wristlets. It's really not itchy at all, which would be the Blue Face Leicester, but it doesn't look anything like Biffle. It really, really doesn't. So I was thrilled with this and went up and I was having a chat with Estelle and she gave me a little gift. She gave me one of their bags, which is just the most brilliant yellow colour. I'm really, really chuffed with that. So thank you Estelle for your that lovely, lovely gesture. Now, I'll show you the one other skein of yarn that I bought. It's not for me. And I bought this from my friend Lindsay Stalls. Lindsay is the Border Tart and she dyes under the label Bloomin' Indigo. So everything she dyes is indigo, and then she has some that are overdyed as well. This is her Ice Maiden. You see that, Stellina? This is indigo dyed, guys. And Lindsay dyes by hand as well. So this is Ice Maiden. This is a 4-ply sock yarn. It's 75% superwash merino, 20% nylon and 5% Stellina. 400 millimetres, 100 grams. Now, the reason I bought this is for my mum. This is going to be her Mother's Day present later this month. I have a skein of this in my stash, which I bought at Perth Festival of Yarn last year from Lindsay, and she'll be returning this year, which is fabulous news. And every time my mum's been to visit, she's tried to steal it. My mum does this. She comes to visit. She always wants to know about my stash, which is all well and good. And then she tries to convince me that I don't actually need certain skeins and that I would really be better off just giving them to her to work with. Nice try, Mum. It occasionally works, but I wasn't taking the bait last time and I knew Lindsay would be there, so that's going to my mum, and that's fine because she doesn't watch me. Now, I said that I haven't actually worked with any of the yarn I bought last year at Edinburgh. Well, I'm not making the same mistake this year. In fact, I've already cast on and worked. So, I wasn't really going to show you any knitting as such, but what I have done is I put a square into my Cozy Memories blanket because I wanted to get just a couple of little minis to put into my mitered square blanket. Just for memories of Edinburgh. I've got a couple that I bought at Perth and I just thought it would be nice to do, especially because I've now done 100 10 gram squares in my blanket. So square 101, how auspicious is that, is this one here, and I'll just hold it against another square so you can see it closely. So this is Easy Knits, because you can't go to Edinburgh without buying from John, who's the Easy Knitter. So this is from his Wickedlets. That's his label. This is a Wickedlet, and these are 20 gram minis, so that's about 80 metres. And it's your usual 75% superwash merino, 25% nylon, and this one's called Party Night. So I have some left over here, and you know what, after seeing how that knits up, because I would have had no idea from the mini, I love that. It's kind of like an oystery kind of dovey grey with all these pops of colours in it, so that is, I'm really happy with that one. And I got another one of his minis as well, so I've got this one here, which is kind of like a creamy oatmeal-y, yeah, kind of oatmeal colour, and it's got yellow tones and orange and kind of warm pinks. This one's Nougat, and again it's the same sort of yarn description on that. That brings us on to the larger skeins that I bought. So it was really funny that I bumped into Foo and Bee of Cosmic Strings, because I'd been to the Be Inspired Fibres booth, which they actually have a shop. There is a shop in Edinburgh, and I went there for the first time when Inga of the Knitting Diaries came over from Iceland, and David from who's This Boy Knits, This Boy Podcasts, we met up with her in Edinburgh, and we went there because we went on a bit of a yarn buying expedition, and I realised that she stocks Knit Cosmic or Cosmic Strings, and I've had some of their yarn before and I love it, even though I've not actually knitted it up. I do love it. So I had not long bought this before I bumped into Foon B, so it was quite funny. Excuse me, my throat's doing funny things. It was really funny to see them and go, look what I've bought. This is shoes. This has been bought in mind because I'm going to do socks for Josh out of this. It's his birthday at the end of next month and he loves the hand-knitted socks I did for his Christmas. So I'd like him to have a second pair. This is Ripple. It's sock yarn. It's 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon. It's 100 grams. It's approximately 425 metres. And Foo and Bee are actually based in Edinburgh as well. Like, look at the depths of the turquoise. I love it. I'm really, really, greens and that. I'm really looking forward to getting this caked up and on. So that, when I've finished the new socks I've started that you haven't seen in my normal podcast yet, once I finish them, that's going on. Okay. Phileas yarn. I saw this in all the teasers that Joe and Mika were putting up on their page. And I was desperate for this because the dyer behind Phileas yarn, so I can't remember her name off the top of my head at the moment. She was Scottish, I think she was Edinburgh based, but she's relocated to York. And she's inspired by travels, all different places that she's travelled and. And I just loved that idea. In fact, her stall was amazing because she had vintage suitcases that had sort of patterns, map material on the inside. She had old maps covering boxes that she had more yarn in. And her display was so well thought out without being pretentious. And she's just such a lovely person herself. I really struggled to choose between two and I thought, really, budget-wise, I have to choose one. So I went with the one that I originally saw online and loved. So this is her Rambler base, which is 80% blue face Leicester and 20% nylon. So it's a sock yarn. It's 100 grams, 365 metres. And this is called Hot Dog in Coney Island. And I'm just completely in love. It's been so, so well dyed. We're coming to the end, guys. I've got four skeins left from two separate dyers. So I'll show the single one that I've got left first. So this is one of Helen's creations. This is Ripple's Crafts. And she's based up in the Scottish Highlands. I was trying to be good this year. I was trying to do mindful purchasing and I saw an amazing yarn at her stall. In fact, I saw two amazing ones and I thought I made my decision. I thought it's really one of the first stalls I'll come to. I will come back, and I went back a few hours later and it was like a plague of locusts had been at her stalls, guys. It was decimated. So Helen's actually another one of the guys or another vendor who's also coming to Perth later this year. So you need to come and look at what she's got because her colourways are fabulous. And she's extremely well priced as well. This is only £13 for the skein. This is 100 grams, which is approximately 420 metres. 75% wool, 25% nylon. It's called Hubble Bubble. And I think the Hubble Bubble is kind of like the base because they've all got numbers. So this is RS35. Look at them, all the different colours. That's going to make some funky socks. Okay. The stall that I did the most damage at was one of the busiest and I eventually managed to get in and I just took what colourways I could on what basis I could, really. So these are all 100% superwash merino. I've got one comfy merino. And I've got two Bouncy Merino. And the difference is that the Bouncy Merino is a high twist and the Comfy Merino isn't. They are all... No, they're not. The Bouncy Merino is 365 metres. The high twist is 365 metres. And the the one that isn't, it's 400 metres, so they're all 100 grams. And I want to do socks. I want to do really, really funky socks, but I think they might be too nice. And this is where I'm falling into the trap of it's too nice, so it's just going to look pretty in my stash. And I need to, if I'm buying it, it needs to get used. And who cares if it's on my feet and no one sees it? Thing is, I know it's there and I have the joy of working with it. So, first up was the one that I absolutely fell in love with. These will be socks, they will be for me, although I'd be very tempted to get another skein just so I could do something like a cowl or whatever. These are yarns by Martin's Lab, which is a company, or they're indie dyers based in Poland. And I have to say that when I saw the teasers online for them, I wasn't particularly taken. So a very, very pleasant surprise to actually see they're still and see all the delicious gorgeousness. And yeah, I went a little bit nuts here. So there's like speckly bits, and there's like, yeah. I'd be very interested to see how it knits up anyway. This is a Bouncy Merino, so it's 365 metres in superwash Merino, and it's called Navajo. And I'm going nuts. These seem to be my colours, what I was really drawn to this year round. Because I did see similar things in other stalls, but not quite as awesome as that one. This is the other Bouncy Merino one. This is Montezuma. So again, there's sort of browns and gingers, and there's greys and pinks and fabulousness. Golds. And then the last, which is World is My Oyster. So I've got 400 metres in this one. So many different colours and techniques, and yeah. So I went a wee bit nuts, but I did stay in budget. I had a wonderful time. Joe and Mika do an amazing job putting on the most fantastic event for us year on year, and they really do. They deserve our thanks and our appreciation, guys, because as director and organiser of a yarn festival, which is much smaller and I'm still quite new to it all, it is a minefield. The amount of things that have to go on in the background that you don't actually realise until you're physically in doing it. It's just phenomenal. So Joe, Mika, I doubt you'll watch this, but you know, if you do, thank you so much for being yourselves, for doing what you do for all of us. And yeah, what an amazing EYF. Thanks, hi, bye for just now to everybody that I spoke to and I met, and all the vendors, and I am one very happy knitting bunny today. I'll return for a normal episode soon, guys, and until then, happy knitting, happy spinning, happy crochet, happy whatever it is you do. I just wish you happiness. Bye for now.